An Academy. Let's crack it.
Hello everyone, I am Nimisha Mishra, a third year student at Nalsar University of Law, Hyderabad. I secured an All India rank of 116 in CLAT 2019. In this video of today, I'll be telling about my various strategies and approaches that helped me out in CLAT. So I'll begin by suggesting every aspirant that first, before choosing CLAT as an option, decide why you want to pursue law and decide why you want to give CLAT. Like, my main reason for giving CLAT was I wanted to explore law as a career option, and I also wanted to explore various fields and the various ways through which I can help a society through as in law as an instrument. So it is a very individualistic approach wherein you get to know why you want to choose a particular, especially law, as a career option. So decide that first and then decide about the preparation. So moving on to the preparation stage, in CLAT 2019, when I gave CLAT, there were 5 subjects. So my preparation at that time was to work on those 5 subjects areas and decide which, and analyze and decide which is my strength and which is my weakness. So it comes naturally when you practice a lot of questions and give sufficient time to every portion of the subject. Like, there were 5 subjects, so it took me 1 to 2 months to study those 5 subjects and then decide by giving various mock tests and giving sectional tests, and that helped me out in deciding which part is my strength and which part is my weakness, and then I worked accordingly. So in my case, like, my strength was maths, logical reasoning and legal reasoning, so I gave sufficient time to them as well. I did not ignore them because they were my strength, but I kept practicing them regularly. And the GK was not my weakness, but there are uncertainties sometimes in terms of the questions they ask in the CLAT. So I gave a little more time to GK and English, and I practiced them regularly, like without any delay. Like, if I had made, I used to make plans and then I used to meet those targets every day. So making a target is the first and the main thing that every aspirant should do. Make your own targets a day before itself, before going to bed, and then next day start your day according to your plans itself. So in this way, your whole year, like, I took a drop. So for me, rather than looking at it as a whole year, I break them into months and into days. So I used to meet my plans every day, the strategy that I used to make a day before, and then I used to work on them every day. So in this way, working day by day, it took months and it became a year, and then it worked well for me. So it's just a suggestion. Look for your own strategy, because everyone's strategy doesn't mean it will, if it worked for me, doesn't mean it will work for everyone. So the first step that you should make before starting your preparation is to make your own strategy. Next, moving on to the analysis part, which is after giving mocks, and especially I would suggest to every aspirant, give mock as much as you can. So like, till the September, give mocks every 2 weeks, like start giving mocks, because just don't be like, once I complete the syllabus then I'll give mock, it will be too late, believe me. So what you should do is prepare for the study for the every subject, and keep studying every day. But just to check how much have you studied, start giving mock tests from the initial months itself. Like, not in the very initial, like, start, take your time, study for 2-3 months and then start giving mocks. So by the time of September, give mock every 2 weeks, and after then, by the time of November, give mocks every week. And this is how consistently you should increase your mock numbers. And not just the mock number, analyze each and every test immediately. It means, like, don't take like a week or 2 weeks to analyze a mock, otherwise you'll forget how you have reached to a certain answer. So analyze them immediately after you get the result or answer key. This helps out really well, and this is the main mantra, I would say, for the doing the mocks. Analysis is a very important part, because through analysis you will get to know which section is your weakest area and which section is your strength, so you can start your preparation accordingly. And it is necessary to get to know about your strength and weakness in the initial month itself, because it takes time and practice to make your own approach for the next 2-3 months. So that is the strategy. And also, one part I would like to highlight here, that I think I made a mistake when I gave CLAT in 2018, that I gave only CLAT. So I think the fear that we face, the fear of when we are giving All India test, exam of All India level. So everyone gets a little nervous and everyone has a fear of fear after seeing the crowd. So what I would suggest is give every law exams that you can give before giving CLAT, if your CLAT is the main exam. So in case like I can give example of MHCT, A-Lit, these exams happens before CLAT. So try giving them as well, and Symbiosis exam. So what happens is you get to face the fear in the initial exams itself rather than the in CLAT directly. So that helped me out in drop year. I gave all the law exams, law entrance exam that happened before CLAT. So in that way, when I came to CLAT, I became very confident in my preparation and in myself as well. So that helped me out. So try giving that all the entrance exam before that. Okay, I can tell a little bit about NALSAR in case that incentivize you to prepare hard. So NALSAR as a university is a very amazing university. It provides a lot of time for every student to explore themselves and explore their area of interest. So in this way, it sets it apart. Like, there is a reason why it is in top 5. So it provides an amazing opportunity and crowd with which you interact every day. So in this way, you get to learn a lot of things. So study hard and it pays off. Like, everyone says that a drop year is a little risky, but I think it's a worth taking risk if you are getting prepare hard and get in the top NLUs. That like it is all worth it. So I would tell every aspirant to work hard, and it's not necessarily that you have to be in NLU. Every law university in this time provide a good opportunity and to explore. But yes, since NLUs are dream colleges of a lot of students, so accordingly, and CLAT is not a rocket science exam. It's a doable. Make your own strategies accordingly and in a timely manner, and implement them every day. So it will work well for everyone. And apart from that, I can also tell about common mistakes that people make. So what they do is sometimes students just neglect one portion. For example, sometimes students say that maths is their weak subject, so they ignore that completely. But remember that sometimes it happens that, like in CLAT 2019, math portion was very easy. So in case any student is completely ignoring math throughout the year, then it would have been definitely paid off to, you know, it would have been created a major hindrance to that person. So don't neglect any subject. You can always score at least some marks out of them, and that will set you apart from other students. So don't neglect, even if it's your weakest area, just work on it. Try to look for the various ways you can work it out, or the easiest approach. There are always a simpler approach to solve a question. So look for that. Practice a lot, because practice will help you in getting comfortable with that section. So I would suggest don't neglect any subject. Keep working on that and it will help you out. And other than that, the other mistake that students make is sometimes a lot of students keep spending like 12 to 14 hours every day. They say that you have to work for 12 to 14 hours. So it's a myth, I would tell you. It's not that. If like in my drop year, I used to go to a coaching center. I used to study there, and then I come back and then I take 4 to 5 hours, like not every day. Sometimes it keeps up and goes. So it's not a fixed rule that you have to spend so every day particular hours, but try to study every day. Don't be like you haven't studied for 3-4 days and then you are studying one day for 12 hours. So it's not how it works. Consistency should be there. Be consistent with your preparation. Study every day and make your own plans. Even if you are not studying all the subjects every day, at least study 3 subjects. That helps you out. Like, do maths every day, because it maths and logical reasoning, because it requires a lot of practice. And English also, English GK, so you have to do every day. So it's like this, make your own plan and study at least 3 subjects every day. So in this way, it will help you in a longer run. And I hope everyone do well in CLAT 2022. And yes, that's all for me. I hope it helps you. It helped everyone. And in case any further doubt, please let me know.